The biggest symptom of an inguinal hernia is a bulge, an asymmetry. Usually they're unilateral, although unilateral meaning on one side, although about 15% of the time they can occur on both sides. But most of the time the parents will identify a bulge. For example, when the child is coming out of the shower or bath and standing and relaxed, that often allows them to see the asymmetry or the bulge down in the groin area. And that's the most common presenting sign of an inguinal hernia. In terms of the symptoms that an inguinal hernia can cause, it can cause pain, some discomfort. It's an intermittent process, so at times the hernia will become bigger when that balloon becomes inflated or the hernia sac is filled with the intestines, for example, versus empty. And when it is filled, it does cause not only a bulge, but some minor discomfort as well. If the hernia becomes stuck, which is incarcerated, in other words, if the hernia sac fills with the intestines and the intestines don't slide back in the abdomen, then you have a situation called incarceration, which can result in significant pain, significant swelling, redness. It can block the intestines and that can cause vomiting. And it's pretty clear at that point that there's something going on to most of the parents. Obviously, we like to take care of the hernia before it reaches that point. Overall, the incidence of a hernia becoming stuck is probably in the range of about 10%, maybe a little bit less for bigger kids. It is higher, however, for premature babies and infants.